Neil would have tantrums, like just tantruming. And he never slept. He used to sleep maybe 2 hours a night, so I didn't sleep for years. And I can remember at nighttime when I was exhausted and he was tired, trying to take a bath with him. And he would be splashing and throwing water and screaming and afraid to go in the bath and afraid to get out of the bath. And I was scared because there was glass, you know, mirrors in the room. And I can remember just bawling and then just praying to God, dear God, please give me the strength to get through this one night. Just give me the strength to get through this bath. That's it. And I'd go to guidance and go to my God and get myself peaceful. And then I'd go to him and I'd say, Neil, ask God for help right now because I need help and you need help and help. And we'd get through the night. My husband and I separated when Neil was 7 years old and divorced when he was 8. So I've been on my own as a single mom raising Neil for the past 4 years. There was a doctor in Maryland, Dr. Stanley Greenspan, who had had tremendous success with children with autism, and I learned all about joining his world. So, for example, if he would spin in circles, we'd spin in circles. And if he would stare at his hand, we'd stare at our hand. In the beginning, I had traditional therapists working with him. They thought sometimes I was a crazy lady because he wasn't doing appropriate things. I started bringing in theater people who had no problem with things out of the ordinary. And if Neil needed to do crazy things, they would be crazy with him and with big affect, and they would join his world until he emerged into our world. When I was ready to go back into the workforce, I didn't know what to do. And the answer came to me really strong: teach children with special needs, acting and movement. So I decided to create a theater program for autistic kids and their siblings, and I called it the Miracle Project.
Welcome.
Thank you.
Your film profiles 11 autistic kids in Los Angeles working to perform a musical. How did you put together the concept for the film, and what made you want to make a film on autism?
I actually didn't want to make a film on autism. And there was a group of people who wanted to make a film about autism. Mm-hmm. And I just started talking with them, really just to guide them and give them advice. But my principal advice to them was, you know, I wouldn't go see a movie about autism.
Oh, really?
Autism is, it's just, you know, it's tough, it's hard, it's painful, it's rough, it's, you know, on the kids, on the parents, and, you know, I think I'd rather go to my root canal appointment than sit through that,
sure,
you know?
Sure, sure.
But I said, if you can find a structure where autism is the obstacle in the movie, not the subject, mm-hmm. and people are the subjects, and there's, you have a group of autistic kids who are trying to accomplish something together, and autism is what they're battling to get there.